Okay, teka lang. Nagbibilang.
Hello everyone.
Hi and welcome to another episode sa ating YouTube channel.
Yes.
And for today, meron tayong tanong na sasagutin kasi may nag-message sa akin. Medyo nahihirapan din ako sagutin.
Oh.
Kasi 'di ba,
so, naghanap ka ng kadamay.
Oo, naghanap ako ng mas okay. Magaling sumagot. Kasi we advocate yung diversification, 'di ba?
Okay.
So, tas may mga iba't ibang klaseng way para mag-diversify.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, ang gusto niyang diversification daw ay mag-invest daw sa mga US dollar denominated na mga investment, like you dollar denominated na mutual funds or probably investing sa mga US stocks, etc.
Yeah.
Ang tanong niya is, paano niya malalaman kung ilang percent nung portfolio niya yung naka-i-invest niya sa foreign denominated funds? Sige nga, sagutin mo nga yan.
Mahirap
ba? Siguro I will share first kung paano ko siya sinagot.
Mahirap kasi...
Bakit?
Hindi ko alam kung paano siya sisimplihan.
Meron kang sagot.
Hindi mahirap dahil mahirap sagutin. Uh-oh. Pero mahirap kasi hindi ko alam kung paano siya sisimplihan. So mauna ka na.
So isishare ko kung paano ko siya sinagot. Okay? So sa akin, of course, as we always tell people, it all starts with their financial goals, di ba?
Mm.
And part of that is, kung mag-invest ka sa US dollar, yung overall na gastos mo, gano'n ba kalaki yung ginagastos mo in US dollar? I mean, I usually tell people that you should invest in the currency that you spend.
Mm-hmm.
So, in this case, sabi niya kasi, since they often do international travel, so, sabi ko, sa isang buong taon, ilang percent nung gastos mo ang naka-US dollar? So, sabi niya, since they do international travel, and sabi niya, meron din siyang mga online businesses na, of course, yung gastos niya sa mga web hosting, etc. Is also in US dollar. Sabi niya, around 10% nung spending niya is in USD.
Okay.
So, sabi ko, maybe it makes sense na yung 10% din ng portfolio niya naka-diversify into US dollar denominated na investments. Yun. So, yun yung initial na sagot ko sa kanya. Pero sabi ko, without really looking into the details of your portfolio and your financial goals, it will be hard to determine kung ano ba yung magandang percentage or portion na allotted. Ayan. So, ang una kong tanong sa'yo is, okay ba yung sagot ko? Okay. Does that make sense?
Pareho tayo dito. Yeah, it makes sense. It actually makes perfect sense. No? Kasi, again, that's why we call it investment vehicle, because they should, yun nga, they should get you to where you wanna be. Diba? So, kunwari, gusto mong to beat inflation. Halimbawa, for your long-term capital appreciation, if you think yung dollar your US dollar denominated investment or offshore investment would beat inflation, then go for it. Okay. Now, it's also good as a diversification strategy because you are already diversifying away country risk. Remember, if you are just invested in the Philippines, like Philippine stock market, Philippine bond, money market fund, time deposit, you're just investing in the Philippines. So whatever happens in the Philippines, maganda leche-leche sa Philippines, di ba?
Buong portfolio
Philippines,
mo.
Buong portfolio mo, nasa Philippines lang. Whereas, if you're invested, for example, in US dollar, kasi when you say US dollar denominated funds, it could be US fund or it could be other international fund that not necessarily US, but the European. Okay? So, imagine if your portfolio, hindi lang Philippines, may US ka, may Europe ka, may global fund ka, if mag- tank yung Philippine market, okay, tapos yung ibang market umaakyat, then you are spared, kumbaga immunized yung buong portfolio mo from that pagbaba ng Philippine market. For example, for the previous one or two years parang down ng previous 1 year down ng Philippine stock market by a very very huge percentage. But like the US stock market, it's still up by around 18-ish, mga 20-ish percent still
before coronavirus.
But still, while down ng Philippine market, US market up siya. So imagine kung puro ka Philippine market, down ka, but kung may US market ka, up ka pa rin.
Uh-oh.
Okay? So it greatly, you know, immunizes your portfolio from yun nga tinatawag natin na country risk.
So ang tanong niya is, how do you determine yung percentage na i-allocate mo?
Okay, depende rin yan dun sa goal mo. Like for example, kung naghahabol ka to beat inflation, then medyo magmamask lang tayo ng kaunti.
Uh-oh.
Kung ilang percent yung dapat nasa Philippine equities, saka yung dapat nasa US market or even global funds.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, magmamath lang tayo ng konti and we'll be doing some research. Basta mm-hmm. may math yan. We really cannot tell right now.
Walang specific formula na investment ng 10% or...
Wala. Uh-huh. Kasi baka mamaya, pag sinuma mo lahat na 10% lang, baka hindi enough yung 10% para mabit yung inflation.
Ah, oo. Kasi meron siyang foreign currency exchange risk.
As well. Kasi, for example, nag-invest ka ng US dollar, tapos at 52, tapos biglang ano ba yung currency movement mo is against you, di ba? So kahit umakyat ka ng like 4%, pero halimbawa lang is nagdown yung exchange rate ng 4%, so zero ka pa rin. Okay, although right now we have some products in the market na alam ko na ang underlying is US pero peso
denominated.
Meron akong ganong alam na product in the market. So you can also scout the market for that one. Or you can just email us and we can research it for you and tingnan natin if it fits your portfolio.
Yung isa kong friend actually naalala ko, mahilig din siya mag-international travel and sabi niya sa akin, in a year daw siguro nagbabudget siya ng mga around $3,000 as pocket money dun sa lahat niya ng ano, lahat niya ng international travel with the family. So sabi ko, it could make sense na you invest around $3,000, na at least it beats the inflation rate, na yun yung naka-invest.
So pwedeng dollar para yun yung fund yan. Dollar bond fund.
Na yun yung ginagamit niya na investment para or savings vehicle para dun sa pocket money nila ng family kapag nag-international travel. So, sabi ko, it would make sense. Kunwari, meron kang $10,000. So, pwede mo siyang i-invest sa isang bond fund or anything that can beat inflation. So, every year, kukunin mo yung $3,000 mo, tapos dagdagan mo ulit ng money. So, meron kang revolving fund para sa mga travels mo in US dollar kasi yun naman talaga yung ginagamit mong denomination when you travel.
That's right. And titingnan din natin, of course, is gaano ba kalaki yung portfolio mo.
Okay. Yeah.
Kasi alam ko, like in sum, it takes a minimum of 1,000 US dollars to invest.
To invest, yes.
So kung halimbawa, ang buong pera mo is 50,000 pesos lang.
Wala yun.
Ba't ka mamahiri sa US dollar? Diba? But if you're talking like you have 50 million pesos, tapos yung $1,000 is maliit lang, then
sobrang liit naman yan.
Super liit. So again, it's also a function of gano'ng kalaki yung portfolio natin if it makes sense to diversify. Again, we always say na you don't invest just for the sake of investing. You do not invest just because you wanna invest or you wanna diversify. It also has to make sense and fit the picture of your portfolio and of your goals.
Alright, so ayun, sana na sagot namin yung tanong. Oo, sana may
sense. Was I simple enough?
Basta actually, the bottom line is, there's no simple formula. Personal finance is personal. So depende talaga sa status mo, sa goals mo, sa capability, resources mo, and yung mga plan sa buhay.
Saka accessibility as well.
Accessibility.
Baka mamaya hindi ka maka-invest sa US dollar, magta-travel ka pa ng 10 kilometers just to invest, diba?
Oo.
Doesn't make sense.
Alright. So I guess that's it for our video this week. So I hope may natutunan kayong bago. So if you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. And please remember to subscribe to our channel and hit that notification bell. Alright, so thank you for watching.
Thank you.
See you again next week. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.